It's a really exciting day here at Bruce Power and here at the Bruce B Nuclear Generating Station. Today, our talented operations, maintenance, and a wide range of nuclear professionals are commencing the fuel load here in reactor number 6. Unit 6 commenced its multi-year refurbishment program in January of 2020, and just last week we announced a substantial completion of that project. What that means is that we're now transitioning Unit 6 from a unit that was in construction to a unit that will be in operation later this year. During our refuel window, our operations and maintenance staff will load our reactor with 5,760 fuel bundles. Each one of these fuel bundles can produce the same amount of electricity as 400,000 kilograms of coal or 400,000 cubic meters of natural gas. What you see going on here at Bruce B and with these fuel bundles is the tip of the spear in the fight against climate change. When Unit 6 reaches its full operation, on any given day, Unit 6 will produce enough clean electricity to power between 800 and 850,000 Ontario homes. The unit will also be a source of life-saving medical isotopes, including cobalt used for sterilization and cobalt that is also used to treat brain tumors and breast cancer. Each of these fuel bundles starts in northern Saskatchewan, and this is led by one of the great Canadian companies, Cameco Corporation. Cameco mines this uranium from our mines in northern Saskatchewan, processes this uranium, and sends all of this material to Port Hope, Ontario, where all 5,760 of these fuel bundles that you can see are assembled. So I'm standing here with T-Crew. These are the nuclear professionals that are going to go in and carry out this evolution. They've done their planning, they've done their preparation, and they've done their training. So thank you for everything. The thousands of people who have worked on this unit have really contributed to our success today. We look forward over the course of the next several weeks to completing this fuel load evolution. And that is one of the first key steps in returning this unit to service later this year.